Let's get it cracking, you guys, with part two of my favorite television shows of all time video. Sit back and relax. Let me know if these are any of the shows that you all know and love growing up. If you haven't watched any of these shows, make sure you check them out. Let's talk down below in the comments section. Now let's get it popping. We all got to see how bad the crack epidemic was in Baltimore through the lens of The Wire. It had all of us shaking in our boots. Nobody wanted to visit Baltimore. I still don't want to visit Baltimore to this day. The Wire debuted on HBO June 2nd, 2002, and it forever changed the landscape of television, of a drama series. It produced some of the best actors ever: Dominique West, Michael K. Williams, Sonya Sand, Wendell Pierce, Idris Elba. This was the first time in the United States we really got to see what he could do, but I remember seeing him on episodes of Absolutely Fabulous, Andre Royo. We had Wood Harris, who played Avon Barksdale, Tristan McWild. I mean, spoiler alert, the episode alone the last season of the show, when Michael McWild's character kills Snoop, child, like, you could never, like, the show was just so fucking good. Michael B. Jordan was on the show, that launched his career. I mean, The Wire was just so fucking good, bro. Like, shows like that don't come along every day. Like, ugh, I wish they could bring it back, but you never want to taint it. So if you've never seen The Wire, have you been living under a rock? Like, do yourself a favor and watch The Wire. I'm talking about somebody that was pissed when HBO canceled How to Make It in America after season two. They canceled it to make room for Girls, of all shows. They didn't give the show the opportunity and the chance that it needed to grow its audience. But from episode one, when it started with "I need a dollar, dollar, dollar is what I need," and we saw these two young dudes in New York trying to make it, it was at a pivotal point in my life where I was just on my grind mode. I was trying to transition in my career. It just changed the scope of my life when I watched this show. The show starred Brian Greenberg, who is one of my favorite actors, who's really never had that breakout role that he needs. He played Ben Epstein, Lake Bell, starred as Rachel Chapman, Kid Cudi. That was his first big role. He played Domingo Brown, Victor Rasuk. He played Cam. I really have been wanting for years for this show to come back on HBO. It was just so New York. It was so hip hop. The way they filmed it, the storylines, the fashions, everything was on point. How to Make It in America was one of the best television shows ever. I still watch episodes on HBO demand. Check it out. You will not be sorry. WGN America's Underground was another show that when it got canceled after season two, I was devastated. I did reviews on Underground both seasons. The show was so dynamic. The show was so vivid and explicit with its betrayal of these characters during the slave days, based in the 1850s Georgia, who band together to escape slavery. It was just one of the best television shows ever. Underground was one of the other only shows that I have ever boohoo cried. And I mean boohoo cried like a baby on certain episodes. The show starred Journey Smollett Bell as Rosalie, Amira Van as Ernestine. Ernestine was every fucking thing, my nigga. Aldis Hodge as Noah, Christopher Maloney as August Pullman, Alano Miller as Cato. The show was just so good, and it was so ahead of its time. We all hoped and prayed that it would get picked up by another network, but it did not. But Underground still lives on. Man, that show was good. Fuck. I mean, what is there not to be said about Will and Grace? It is a show that is on NBC. They're in its second run of the show. It was rebooted 2 years ago. They're in its final season again. The show is just phenomenal. It stars Deborah Messing, Eric McCormick, Sean Hayes, Megan Mullally. It is just by far one of the funniest shows ever. I think Will and Grace was one of the shows that really got America comfortable with homosexuality. We got to see this homosexual man and his best friend trying to navigate life and love and work and friendship in New York City. It's just a laugh riot. Rosario's character, the actress that played her, may she rest in peace, Stan, who we never got to see, it was just so fucking funny. I have seen every episode of Will and Grace. Every time it comes on, I stop what I'm doing. I'm so sad to see the television show ending again, but the second run was even as good as the first one. It's a show that can just continue to live on and on and on. So shout out to Will and Grace. Based on the Letty DeBesch books by Blake Crouch, the seductive thriller Good Behavior centers on con artist Letty Raines and her inability, despite good intentions, to consistently live a clean life. Fresh out of prison, Letty attempts to reunite with her 10-year-old son and keep in regular contact with her parole officer, whose motives for helping her are quite questionable. This show only lasted 2 seasons, but Good Behavior was by far one of my favorite television shows of all times. It starred Michelle Dougherty, who everybody knows from Downton Abbey, as well as Juan Diego Botto as Javier. This show was just phenomenal. The writing, the acting, Letty's character was so complex. She was funny. She didn't take any shit from her anybody. I love that it was a multiracial casting. I love that she had a mixed son. I love that she had a Puerto Rican love interest, or the Mexican, I forgot what he was, but the show was just bomb as fuck. I was so mad when they didn't get a season 3. This is just another television show with great writing, great acting that got canceled. Good Behavior, Good Behavior was on TNT. So if you want to check out season 1 and season 2, check out Good Behavior on TNT On Demand. Year before last, I came across Peaky Blinders on a humbug one day when I was on Netflix searching for something to watch. And I'm so happy that I stumbled across this series from the BBC. It is by far one of the best television shows ever written. The show stars Cillian Murphy as Thomas Shelby. The show centers around his character, who is a returning war hero, but he has bigger ambitions than just running the streets. When a crate of guns goes missing, he recognizes an opportunity to advance in the world, because crime may pay, but legitimate business pays better. The show is one of the best gangster mob television shows ever. It's up there with The Sopranos, with Boardwalk Empire. Cillian Murphy as Thomas Shelby is everything. He's sexy, he's brooding, he's moody, he's an all-out killer and thug. His brother Arthur Shelby is fucking batshit crazy. His nephew Michael has betrayed him in the last season. His aunt Polly is everything. She is a fucking G. If you're looking for a great mob show based in the early 1900s, based in Ireland, this is the show for you. Peaky Blinders on Netflix. Different World is a spinoff of The Cosby Show, and the show was based around Denise Huxtable going off to college, to Hillman College, and her being around all these new people, around a divorced freshman who was Jaleesa, around Southern Belle named Whitley, about a math major named Dwayne, and his best friend Ron, and then Colonel Taylor, aka Dr. War. A Different World changed my life. It was a show that made me want to go to college when I was younger. It made me want to live that college experience. Everybody fell in love with Whitley and Dwayne's love story. I have seen that wedding episode. I don't know how many times that wedding episode will go down in history as one of the best television weddings of all time. When he stopped that wedding, Whitley Gilbert's character was everything. She was sassy, she was funny, she could read, she could dress down, she was spoiled. She was just every fucking thing. Kadeem Hardison was great as Dwayne Wade. He was so cute to me growing up. I wanted to date him. Cree Summers was on the show, Daryl M. Bell, Don Lewis, Lisa Bonet, Debbie Allen. The show was just fucking fantastic. If they're going to do a reboot of any show, it should be A Different World. A lot of people weren't happy with the ending, but I, however, loved every single season and every single moment of Game of Thrones. Game of Thrones, from beginning to end, to me, was great. I know what the writer's intentions were. I see where they were going with everything. Despite the last season being a slightly rushed, you still can't take away the overall impact that Game of Thrones had on the culture, on television. Millions upon millions of people were tuned in every fucking Sunday, especially the last three seasons, to see how everything was going to play out. We were glued to our televisions, the lives and the stories of Daenerys Targaryen, Jon Snow, Sansa, Arya Stark, Cersei Lannister, Tyrion, Jaime Lannister. We were all so enthralled and so fully invested in these storylines, the acting, the cinematography, the wardrobe, the set locations. They filmed this show all across the world. It was so much money put into the last season. I think the budget was over $100 million. I can't wait for the new episodes and the new series spinoffs of Game of Thrones to air. Like, Game of Thrones will go down in history as one of the best television shows of all time. It changed my life. It was one of the other television shows that I boohoo cried. The episode, spoiler alert, when Jon Snow was stabbed and I thought that he had actually died, nigga, I cried like somebody in my family died. There are only a few television shows that have ever impacted me like that, and Game of Thrones is the one of them. The Wonder Years tracks life in the turbulent late 1960s and early 70s through the eyes of the increasingly less innocent Kevin Arnold. Narrated by an adult Kevin, the show follows him as he faces first love and the obstacles of life with best friend Paul. Man, Wonder Years is just so nostalgic, from the opening song, "Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song. I hope I don't sing out of key. Oh, baby, try a little help without me." Man, that show was everything. It debuted January 31st, 1988, and the last episode was in 1993. The show starred Danica McKellar as Gwendolyn. She played Winnie. Fred Savage played Kevin Arnold. We had his father, we had his brother, and his sister's character on there. The show was just everything. It's so nostalgic. It was so a great representation of the 60s and that whole era and the innocence of that time and the war and how racism and everything that just went on during that time period. The show was just so good. If you've never seen The Wonder Years, get your whole entire motherfucking life. The love story between Winnie and Kevin, oh, it still makes me swoon to this day. Thelma Mama Harper is the quick-tempered, blue-haired matriarch of the Harper family who lives with son Vint and his wife Naomi, who were forced to move into Mama's basement after losing money and a business deal gone awry. After Vince's kids from a previous marriage leave the house, Mama's delinquent grandson, Bubba, is ordered to live with his grandmother after being released from juvenile hall and placed on probation. Iola Boylan, Thelma's friend and neighbor, is a frequent visitor to the Harper household, which is often the site of bickering between abrasive Mama and her loved ones. Vicki Lawrence stars as Mama, a character she originated in sketches on the Carol Burnett Show. You can still catch episodes of Mama's Family on the Logo Network. I mean, Vicki Lawrence just knocked it out of the park with this character, Thelma Harper, that she created on the Carol Burnett Show. I remember being a little girl watching Mama's Family on Channel 11 every night before I went to bed, before going to school. It was just so fucking funny. Mama cursed everybody the fuck out. Vint was dumb as shit. Naomi was so beautiful. Bubba could get it. Alright, you guys, and that concludes part two of my favorite television shows of all time video. Stay tuned for part three. What will make the list? Can you guess? Let me know down below what you think that the last video will consist of. what television shows you think are my favorites. Let's talk down below. Let me know what are your favorite television shows of all time. Thank you all for watching this video. Make sure to thumbs up this video, like and subscribe, and hit that notification bell button. And I will see you guys on part 3 of this series. Bye.